they didn't understand or didn't want to understand that it was a physical illness. So they were trying to force Lynn to do things, believing that she could make herself better.
If ever I left her bedside, immediately some member of staff would come along and start questioning her as to what was really wrong. Why did she not want to get better? Desperately trying to find a reason to pin her condition on.
Believe me, you wouldn't choose to lie here day upon day, unable to move. You wouldn't choose this life when there's so much out there that's enjoyable and interesting and challenging and wonderful.
This is as important as any other significant major illness, whether it's cancer, heart disease, AIDS.
It is a complex, chronic, multisystem illness. It is not a psychiatric illness. It's not a illness which is associated with mental and behavioural disorders.
Patients are suffering neglect by the medical services and are largely forgotten, both by the professionals and also by the media.
The government sold its soul really on this. They said this is the way we're going to treat this illness. We know what the illness is, it's psychiatric, it's mental and behavioural. We're going to use these techniques and that's it.
I just lived in this constant fear of what was going to be forced upon me next. Not only had I lost all control of my body and lost my whole life, I was denied any say in anything that happened to me.
Any input that we had from psychiatrists was very, very destructive. Instead of helping, it nearly killed Lynn.
Sophie was put in a locked ward. It was a locked room within a locked ward of the mental hospital.
Her physical disease was being treated as a mental illness, and that's why she died.
These true horror stories where the families have really been abused by the professionals and by the court process in general. There's been no publicity for these cases and neither has there really been any justice.